I'm Dr. Ruth Gates, and I'm the director of the Hawai'i Institute of Marine Biology. That's my official title, but actually I'm a coral reef biologist. And we have a short series now about corals, what they are, what's happening to them as climate change intensifies, and what can be done about it. As a marine biologist, I study the organisms that live in the ocean. You know, I was fascinated by them in my early life. I was lucky to watch Jacques Cousteau, who was arguably the first person to really use underwater photography to create documentaries that unveiled the secret life that was under the surface of the ocean, and to really focuses on the organisms and how crazy and diverse they are. You know, I started saying I would be a marine biologist when I was 11. And the funny thing is, I was an athlete and at school, and so my teachers all said, oh no, you can't be a marine biologist, you're gonna be an athlete. And I kept saying, I like athletics, but actually I want to be a marine biologist. And they kept saying no. And in fact, I failed one of my exams. And they said, see, you can't be a marine biologist. But I just kept going and I pushed on, did an undergraduate degree in marine biology, went on to do a PhD in marine biology and focusing on corals. And I've studied corals ever since. And really, that story tells you something about what it takes to be a successful marine biologist. You just have to keep going when people tell you that you can't do something. And be prepared to see things that you didn't expect. There is no end to knowing. You just open new doors and there are new questions that arise every time you find an answer to one thing. A new set of questions arise that are exciting and one step further along the knowledge pathway. So I think if there's one thing that I feel students perhaps are too focused on, is the end of a thing, the getting of a degree, when actually for me, it's all about the process of getting to a place, not the destination. I spent almost 1,000 hours underwater when I was doing my PhD, and I studied intensely the organism and interacted directly with it. As you go on, you distance yourself a little bit from the actual doing and do much more of the thinking. You're expanding your skill set, adding more pieces. And so at this point in my career, of course, I'm all about resourcing. I'm all about guiding what gets done, helping other people do the science and collaborating them with other people with skills that can help them too. You know, I've been a coral biologist. I was lucky to do my PhD on the North Shore of Jamaica and I lived there to do it. And then I went on in my career and I ended up at UCLA. And UCLA is a great school, has great marine biology programs, had great coral biologists. But to do my work, I had to travel to another place. And so I do that 2 weeks a year. And invariably, I made huge mistakes when I was in the field. And so I'd constantly be saying, God, I wish I'd done it this way, but I hadn't. And I had to wait till the next time I went into the field to correct. This job came up at HIMB, and I had been here, I'd visited, and I thought then, wow, imagine being on a living reef for 365 days a year. I can course correct my mistakes immediately they happen. And now I've been here for a while, I realize it's so much more than that. It sits in the middle of a bay that is surrounded by residential communities. And in our work, it's imperative that we collaborate with our community. And we do so in many, many different ways. HIMB, the University of Hawaii at Manoa, really focused on this agenda of science that serves people and the world. Now we see that the more we translate our information, the greater number of people will engage with it. And those people often come back to us and said, we want to help, what can we do? That's the conversation that you want, a community of actors, not just scientists working away in their small silos.